All right, guys, so I'm working on my Steel BR600. Now, I asked a question in a video ago. Would the handle, what's happening is my handle is broke. Take a look. This handle, see the knob came off of it. It's basically, it's broke. So I need another one. And so what I'm gonna do is either I'm gonna see if the mechanism out of this one, off the BR350, would fit. And I asked that question, would the one off of this one fit? And I can't remember who it was. A couple of people said, yes, they're interchangeable because they're steel. So I'm gonna take them loose here and I'm gonna find out. And if I can make the switch, I'm gonna switch them out here in a few minutes. Here's the 350, here's the 600. I already got this one taken loose, and I see what I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna see how similar they are. Let me see what I got. All right, guys, I got the two of them loose. As you can see, this is the good one. And this is where this mechanism set right there. As long as this connects into this, in which it will, I think the power just need to be stabilized somewhere. I don't know that for sure, but from what I'm looking at, looks like all that needs to be is just stabilized, these wires here. I'm going to put them in there, and then I'm going to put it back together, and I'm going to see if I can make this thing work. Let me try. All right, guys, so we're going to see right now if the handle off the 350, you remember in the last video, I asked you if you thought the handle off the 350 BR steel blower would work on the BR600. Here's the old handle. This is the one off of the 600. That's the one off the BR600. And the one off the BR350 is on. Let's give it a pull and see if it works. And there it is, guys. It's working. So the answer is yes. The handle off the BR350 will work. All right, guys. Johnny with Upscale. So we're at a new property today. And this is gonna be a clean up. Take a look at this driveway. That bad boy had been edged since the weed eater was invented. That side over there, I think I'm just gonna put some weed kill on that part of it. I'm not gonna spend a whole lot of time burning up string with that, but I'm gonna edge this up and get this looking good for. And this is gonna be a different kind of property, guys. An elderly person lives here on fixed income. And we're gonna help them out. I ain't gonna say it's gonna be free, but it's gonna be so close to it. But it's still, we gotta get it cleaned up. You see that? This is gonna be a clean up right there. Look at that. So, and man, it's 12 o'clock and it's already in the 90s. I think it's like about 96 right now. So we're gonna get to work. We don't have to trim any bushes. But look at that. We're gonna get to work on it. And I'm gonna edge this bad boy, guys. again with a string trimmer. Let me get to work.
Thank you.
right, guys, we're done with it. And believe it or not, didn't take that long. Let's take a look at the back real quick. We've got to clean this little shed up right here to recover. There's a big old tree root right there. See that big boy? Here's the back. Let it mold and clean up. This bad boy's growed up, y'all. And here's the deal on this one. This one wasn't free, but like I say, for a person that's on fixed income, and you know, people come to you and they ask the lawn guy for help. One of my clients asked me if I would help, and they didn't bite their tongue. Asked me, you know, would I help? So what I did this one for just regular maintenance. And we are getting it on every 2 week basis, so I didn't mind checking out. So I didn't charge him a cleanup fee, but you can see this is every bit of $150, y'all. All the cracked grass and stuff. Take a look at the front, take a look at the driveway. Look at that driveway. And you saw it, guys. That was where it shrinked from. Now, you know, they wasn't paying for me to get a stick edge and a shovel and all that. We'll work the edge as we go. But there it is. We're headed on to the next one. Cleanup done.